First, we'll try to relate to what my today's duty has been assigned to speak to you. And the subject I am speaking on is Gurmat as the concept of individual. Or you can call it in English, the most inner, more reality. Or in the abstract form, you can say it, let me go to my innermost chamber, which normally you forget. Because my problem is, this morning I was telling God, I say, hey God, you send us here and you are everywhere. Why you want us to mess around? And the answer came, don't you want your ego to play a part? Try that way. I didn't want to tell you what I said in return, but that's between me and God, so let's leave it there. Gur ki mat lai aane, bhagat bina bau dube syaane. Take the Guru wisdom, O innocent, without bhakti. Pao gati. End of the unisonness. Try to understand the meanings. When the word is action, act-shun, separate, try to go by the nad. Words do not come because you know them. Word came as we human beings started developing. Language relates to the evolution of the person. Language does not relate to the revolution of the person. Revolving per meter is not the meter of measurement of human life. It is the alma mater in the human metric system which relates to human ideology, identity and its projection, and that is the secret of success. Action, shun, shunya, zero. When you say take action, it means do something and do it complete. It must stop. It must have stop in it. That's mean action. You think action is keep on acting. That's what you think. I mean, that's how you are divergent from a reality. Word is act and shun. Attend, shun. If you are in the army, the command is not giving ever in two words without emphasizing their weight. Attention. Action. That's how the commanding officer will command, and that's how we'll listen. And we'll right turn. You will never find a command in the history of any army, how I mean, say Nigerian army even, that they are going to give a command saying, right turn. Nobody does it. Because emphasis is not in the sound, emphasis is in the completion of the movement and activity. Word is Gurmat, Guru ki mat. And the concept of counseling, concept of education, concept of awareness, concept of consciousness, concept of intelligence is ingrown in woman in Sikh Dharma. It's a very in thing. Because when you live and when you act, your act is not complete if your intelligence does not tell you how Guru says about it. You even do not know how your feelings are about it. You even do not know how your emotions are without it. You even do not know whether the paraphernalia around you is going to guide you right. You even do not have the homework done for it. You do not know the intelligence and the counterintelligence of your own one action. You can be totally impulsive. You can be totally opportunist. You can be totally swayed by the tidal wave of your feelings. You may be totally dreaming and imaginating, and your dream and imagination may be so driving force that you are just in sleep. You have no touch with realities. It can all be. By doing so, you think you can win? No. Neither you can win, nor anybody can win. What should you do? Run to your counselor? You can go. Run to your advisor? Call him on the phone? No. What you can do? Sit down, close your eyes and meditate? No. Ask your inner voice? You are already confused. Your emotions are hitting you. Your commotions are guiding you. Opportunity is right there. You do not know what you are doing. At that time, Guru's word come handy. A counselor which stays even. When mind is doing number, Guru has said so many things about mind, and one line can come handy. If you are Sikhs, and you happen to confess you are Sikhs, you are or not, nobody is judging you, but you look Sikhs, let us put it that way. And when your mind is playing a game, and you are in totally commotional flow of the mind, and mind is pushing like a tidal whale, hitting you against the banks of your senility, and you are trying to act and falling apart into insanity, why don't you ask your mind one thing? Mantu jyot srupa. Oh my mind, you are the light of God. What are you doing this mess with me? When your mind drives you away from your reality because of passion, because of flesh, why don't you ask your mind, eh mana merya, tu sadara ranale. Oh my mind, be with God all the time. And when minds overwhelm you, overtakes you, and then skid with him and smile. Man tu maram pulayenda. Oh my mind, you always try to puzzle me. What I'm trying to tell you, in Guru's walk of life, mind is a identity, is a servant, is a communicator between the soul and you, but it is not you. You have to accept the basic fundamental situation. Mind is not you. Mind is your first servant. Granted, very powerful thing. Granted, it can totally mess you up. Granted, it can make you up. Granted, it tells you everything. Granted, it is three, negative, positive, and neutral. But still, it is not you. So when you follow your mind totally, you do not follow you. Do you understand what I'm saying? That is Gurmat. When you follow your emotions, you follow your feelings, you follow your thoughts, you follow your desire, you follow your impulse, you follow your very mind, that is not your total being. Therefore, you cannot follow a one-third of you, two-thirds of you, and you can be complete. Most of the people are whispering these days, oh well, forget about Yogiji, he doesn't understand feelings and emotions. I am the feeling, I am the emotions. I feel feelings and I feel emotions. But I have spent 24 years to learn to feel feelings and feel emotions and then process them through intelligence and through consciousness. When I learned that, I became a yogi. I became a master. I became a Mahantantric. But it didn't satisfy me. I did not become a Sikh. I was a Sikh. As good Sikh as you can be. But I was not a Sikh. I did not even touch the shore of my Sikh faith. I knew Guru. I read Guru. I understood Guru. I taught Guru. I shared Guru. But I was not a Sikh. I didn't even touch the inlands of the Sikhism, Sikh Dharma, or the Sikh domain, or the Sikh Dham. I had a perfect self-control. I did learn what a Riddhi Siddhi Naunidhi is. I also learned how these tattvas and chakras interrelate and work. I did a wonderful work. I did it as a scientist. Then I found it out, it's not true. There is something missing. Because within me I found out my eyes becoming bigger than me. I was like a lake which was totally going to break the banks. I wanted to understand what is that something better than that. Then I understood, knowing all things do not make a change at all. The only thing which makes change is when you put a president of the company over the company. In my company, there was a mind. In my company, there was a me. In my company, there was emotions, there was feelings, commotions, intelligence, consciousness, knowledge and achievement. Having all that, I found I am without the president. I have a whole body, but I have no head. Which can guide me? Which can make me understand life? When I put the Guru's word to preside over me, I understood the mantra Vaheguru. Before that, I was a relative to Vaheguru. I was relating to Vaheguru. I was so fanatic, I used to put Vaheguru in everything. But that was my shield to silent people. That was my shield to win people. That was my shield to edge over people. That was my shield to control people. But it was not my reality. But when Vaheguru presented, then two things born out of me. One was kindness, other was compassion. These are the two legs on which truth walks. And then I understood what Guru Nanak said, Aad Sach, Jugaad Sach, Hai Bhi Sach, Nanak Hosi Bhi Sach. Before that, I was the most powerful man you can experience. Very clever, very fast, presuppositedly knowing all, talking all, doing all, manipulating everything. One day I look at myself and I said, is this is the limit to man can come to? That it can rain all over and where he's sitting it doesn't rain? Is that the, when man is sitting in the burning sun, if the clouds put a shadow on him, he becomes the avatar? Is that it? Is that if I all the power of the world I can twist and toss the whole universe, is that the limit of the man? I asked that question. But that day, Guru was presiding in my heart, the Shabd Guru, the word of the Guru. It hit! I said, hey, Yogi! Stop! Shut up! I am the one who is presiding on this throne. Your abstract is wrong, and so is your conception. I say, oh, Mr. President. Well, it's a company meeting. I say, sir, well, tell me, what is the management policy? How to run this company? How to run this kaam, krodh, lobh, mohankar, me, ego, blah, 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 relation, relatives, things, non-things, poverty, richness, effects, non-effect, climate, season. Tell me, sir. The answer came, Je jukchare yaar ja hor tu suni hoy, Nava khanda me janiye naal chale sab ko, Changa nao rakhaye ke jas kirat chagle, Je tis nadar na vai ta vaat na puche ke. If you don't see the unseen in everything before you see something, you see nothing. You are blind. If you don't hear the word of the Guru before hearing anybody else, you are deaf. And if you don't speak the word of the Guru before your ego takes over, you are dumb. Now tell me, you are deaf, dumb and blind, and you say you are the light of the God, you are the Supreme Being. And I say, yes, Mr. President, I'm sorry, I agree. And then I learned the next body of the Japji, Manne ki gat kahi na ja, je ko kahe piche pashta. Agreeing to it, agreeing to the command, obeying the command is excellently solving your problem out of the mess and the mud you are in. This is how you come out of the pit. When you take the word of the Guru and apply it, that will supply you opportunity to get out of the tragedy. And that is how Gurmat works. I can tell you, the Sikhs, all five kakars, perfect. Everything, forget about it. You talk to them, there's nothing. And there are some who are political, so political that you want to vomit. And they are so religious that you want to run. They look good, they smell good, they talk good, but they are not good. They are missing something. Because they are on a trip. Sikh has only one trip to walk to. Between the two poles, he has only one line. It's called the line of kindness and compassion. These are the two fundamentals on which the house of Guru Nanak has been established. And what do you mean by kind? What kind of person you are? What your kinds are? So many kinds and so many kind of circumstances and so many kinds of varieties, so many kinds of temptation, so many kinds of needs, so many kinds of situations to deal with, so many dreams, so many kinds of dream. Kind is a stimulant of the totality. So are you going to surrender to the kind? Which kind you are? You are of the kind, when all hits you, when all hits you, all hits you, you pat it with a word. Thank you for waking me up. When Guru was hit by Guru's son, old Guru, very old, and the son of Guru hit him. He didn't say, "You hurt me, you should be ashamed of it. No, I am the Guru, you are only the son, don't do it." No, not at all. He said, "Thank you, I am old, I am feeble, I am meek. By kicking me, you have awakened me." You know what in turn he did? What that old Guru did? That meek Guru did? Anand paya meri maaye, sat guru me paya. Then he started explaining the state of bliss. Our no function is complete without singing that. He came so kind, so compassionate, that he gave humanity a tool so that their anger may not turn into violence, to rudeness, to unkindness, to ungraceful activities. Emotions and feeling when get blended, emotions and feelings when get blended, they create a reaction. If intelligence and consciousness does not get blended into, that's Tantra. Tantra is width and the length. They have to weave with each other. The weaving part is, tantric part is, that when emotions and feelings are woven with intelligence and consciousness, these are the fours. Who preside over it? Guru's word. Shabd Guru. Sikh believes in Shabd Guru. Sikh feels in Shabd Guru. Sikh lives in Shabd Guru. Shabd Guru, where he gave his head. That's what Amrit is. What is Amrit? Amrit is you offer your head to the Shabd Guru. That means when we come before Sri Guru Granth, we bow, we touch our forehead. That is Shabd Guru. We bow in salutation. And we say, we'll accept you. Matha tekna. Take means where you rest. Where your infinite rest is, that's called take. Take means infinite rest. Where you infinitely rest, it is called take. What is your ultimate coverage, shield, it is called oat. Kai kotan jeevan ki oat mein na payo parmeshwar har raya. Oat, satguru teri oat, oat tu guru. You are my shield. Matha take. Matha take. Take matha. Why matha? Because this forehead carries your destiny. And what we do is take this destiny, put it before the Guru and saying, you are my ultimate aid, help, stay. You are my base. Matha tekna is not salutation. I'm talking of English translation. English translation, I came before the Sri Guru Granth, the holy book, and I gave my salutation and I pay my respect. Now look at that. Look at that. And look at the reality. How feeble is the action against reality. When a Sikh comes, he folds his hands, he neutralizes himself, he bends. It means he goes for a stability of his base and then he puts his destiny before the Guru and says, I accept thee, O my ultimate shelter, O my ultimate rest, O my ultimate strength, O my ultimate base. This one action is Matha Tekna. And when anything else comes or goes, the word of the Guru speaks silently within you. That's why you are Nyare. That's why you are Khalsa. That's why you are excellent. That is the only way you shall survive above all. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa.
Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.
के साथ न जाए सा